Dear students, in this video we will construct the correlation diagram of D2 octahedral as well as tetrahedral complexes. So for this construction we again we have to follow some steps. First we have to obtain the energy states of weak field complexes, then we have to obtain the energy states for strong field complexes. Then we arrange these energy states in increasing order of energy, and we put the energy states of weak field complexes at the extreme left and that of strong field complexes at the right extreme. Then we correlate the same symmetry terms by connecting them via dotted lines. For metal ions in D2 configuration, the splitting states are 3F, 3P, 1G, 1D and 1S. So these are the free metal ion terms. These free metal ion terms, when they form octahedral complexes in weak field, then they further split into their Mulliken terms. So this 3F can split into 3T1G, 3T2G and 3A2G. So this is the energy order of these splitting terms. Then 1D will split into T2G and EG. Then 1G will split into T1G, T2G, EG and A1G. S1, the Mulliken term of 1S term is 1A1G, while that of 3P is 3T1G. So overall we can calculate the total microstates for D2 configuration. For this there are 21 microstates. We can calculate easily the number of microstates by multiplying this multiplicity with its degeneracy. So its degeneracy is 7 and its multiplicity is 3. So this is responsible for 21 microstates. In case of 3p state, there are 3 multiplicity and its degeneracy is 3. So 9 microstates will be possible for this term. For 1g, its multiplicity is 1 and its degeneracy is 9. So again, it is responsible for 9 terms. And 1d is responsible for 5 terms and 1s is responsible for 1 term. So I think total will be 9 plus 9 18 18 plus 5 23 24 25. So this will equals to 45. So the total number of microstates will be 45. We can also calculate for these states, for these Mulliken terms, we can calculate the total number of microstates, because total number of microstates as well as the terms 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So if weak field complex is generating 11 terms, then the strong field complex should also be generate 11 terms. Likewise, if there are total multiplicity should be equal to 45 in case of weak field complex as well as in case of strong field complexes. So we can calculate the microstates for these Mulliken terms also. So for this A2G, this will equals to 3 into 1, that is 3, because its degeneracy is 1, so it is responsible for 3 states. Its degeneracy is 3, triply degenerate, so its degeneracy is 9, and again its 9 degeneracy, its degeneracy is 2, and multiplicity is 1, so microstate will be 2. Here 3 microstates are possible, here 1 microstate is possible, 2 microstates possible, 3 microstates possible, 3 microstates possible. In this case, 1 microstate is possible, and for this 3P state, because its multiplicity is 3 and its degeneracy is 3, so total 9 microstates are possible. The total number of microstate will become 45. So this is the splitting or obtaining the different energy state for weak field D2 configuration octahedral complex. So these are the terms for free metal ion, while these are the terms for octahedral complex with the same multiplicity, with the same number of microstates. Now we have to obtain the energy states for strong field complexes. So in case of strong field complexes, L and S, that are orbital angular momentum quantum number and this is spin angular quantum number, are not good quantum numbers. So we will represent the electronic configurations for the strong field complexes. So strong field complexes can be represented by electronic configuration. So what will be the electronic configuration? The electronic configuration of strong field complexes in the increasing order of energy are T2G2. So two electrons will remain in the T2G energy level orbital. Then this is the first excited state, that is T2G1 EG1, and this is the second excited state whose electronic configuration will become EG2. So this will be of lowest energy and this will be of highest energy electronic configuration. So the states or energy levels from these configurations can be obtained from direct product of the representations. We have already discussed in the table of products in the when we have calculated the ground state term for traditional metal complexes in the previous video. So we have to calculate the energy levels for these different configurations. So these comes from direct product. So in this case, there is one electron is in T2G1, T2G2, and other is also present in T2G orbital. So there are two electrons, they are present in T2G orbital. So the product of this T2G, so we can represent it as T2G1 and T2G1. So its multiplication is T2G1, T2G1. So T2G1, T2G1 means it one T2G has 3 degeneracy and other T2G will also have 3 degeneracy. So total degeneracy become 9. So for this configuration, this can be represented as T2G1 and T2G1. So this has 3 degeneracy, this has 3 degeneracy. So T3s are 9. So total degeneracy become 9. It's like P2 configuration. It's like a P2 configuration. So in case of P2 configuration, we can easily calculate the number of microstates. They are 9. Likewise, here also the total number of microstates become 9. So it's reduced. The product of these T2G1 and T2G1 is equal to A1G, EG, T1G and T2G. So it has 1 degeneracy, it has 2 degeneracy, it has 3 degeneracy, it has 3 degeneracy. So total degeneracy becomes equal to 9. So its degeneracy should be equal to the degeneracy of these generated terms. So this is also 9, this is also 9. Now the first excited state configuration is T2G1, EG1. So T2G has 3 degeneracy, it has 2 degeneracy. So the total degeneracy will become 3 to 6. Again, it can split into two terms. Its product is T1G plus T2G. So its degeneracy is 3, its degeneracy is 3. So total degeneracy becomes 9. So it has 9 degeneracy, it also has 6 degeneracy, it also has 6 degeneracy. In case of EG2 configuration, this is the second excited state configuration. So in this case, one EG has 2 degeneracy, other EG has 2 degeneracy. So total degeneracy is 4. Their product is equal to A1G, A2G and EG. We have already discussed in the previous lecture that is based on the evaluation of ground state term of transition metal complexes. We have shown the table, product table for octahedral complexes. So again, A, degeneracy of A is 1, degeneracy of A2 is also 1, and degeneracy of E is 2. So total degeneracy becomes 4. A means singly degenerate, E means doubly degenerate, T means triply degenerate. So total degeneracy becomes 4. So degeneracy of these generating states and this electronic configuration should be same. Now, if we calculate the microstates for T2G2 configuration, So I have already told that this T2G2, because it has triple degeneracy, like p orbital. P orbital also has triple degeneracy. So it is like a p2 configuration. So in case of T2G also, maximum number of electrons can be 6. So we can calculate microstates for T2G2 configuration. So total number of microstates with the help of formula we can calculate. That will be equal to 15, because it is similar to the p2 configuration. So total number of microstates will be 15. Now its generating terms are A1G, EG, T1G and T2G. So the number of microstates should be equal to the T2G2. Their total number of microstates should be equal to this, because their degeneracy is equal to this. So the number of microstates generating here, it should be equal to that of T2G2. So we can thought that either A1G and EG or T1G or T2G should be in should have the triplet three multiplicity. So either A1G and EG both, or T1G or T2G, they should have three multiplicity. So if it is three, so the microstates will become 3 3 are 9, plus 3 12, plus 2 14, plus 1 15. Then total number of microstate will become 15. So it may be triplet, it may be triplet, or if they are singlet, then these two should be triplet. So if this is triplet, 3 2 are 6, this is triplet, 6 plus 3 9, this has 3 degeneracy. They are singlet, then 3 plus 3, then it becomes equal to 15. So A1G and EG should may be triplet, or T1G or T2G may be triplet. So we have to decide which term will be the triplet, so that the total number of microstate of these terms will be equal to that of T2G2 configuration. So these can be obtained by multiplicity of terms, can be calculated with the help of lowering of symmetry or descent in symmetry. So we can calculate what terms should have the triplet multiplicity. For that we have to lower the symmetry of this configuration, T2G2 configuration. So this T2G2 configuration is for octahedral complex. Now we should reduce it to C2V point group. So if we reduce this to C2V point group, then they can split further into non-reducible representations. Again, in C2V symmetry, this T2G can split into A1, B1 and B2. This T1G can split further into A2, B1, B2, and this EG can split into A1 plus A2. So if we lower the symmetry, this can be helpful in finding out the multiplicity of the term which should have the triplet state. So if we reduce this octahedral to C2V, then this can reduce to these terms. T1G can reduce to A2 plus B1 plus B2, and EG can reduce to A1 plus A2. A and B means singly degenerate. So this is singly degenerate, this is singly degenerate, this is singly degenerate. So total degeneracy is 3. Its degeneracy is also 3 because it is triplet state. Again, A, B, B. Singlet state, singlet state, singlet state. So total degeneracy becomes 3, and it is also triplet degenerate. In case of A and A, singly degenerate, so total degeneracy becomes 2, and it also has 2 degeneracy. So the term arising from these terms, they should have equal degeneracy and equal number of microstates. Now in case of T2G2 configuration, then we got the two combinations, A1 B1 plus B2 into A1 B1 into B2, because this is the product of T2G1 into T2G1. this is the product of T2G1 into T2G1. So for one T2G1, A1 B1 plus B2. For other T2G1, it is A1 B1 B2. So these can be the product of these two C2V point group terms. Now we can arrange the two electrons, because it is T2G2, it is octahedral field. In octahedral field, if we reduce it to C2V field, then we can find that these are three new energy terms, A1, B1 and B2. So these two electrons can be arranged accordingly. These two electrons may be here, these two electrons may be here, or these two electrons may be in B2 orbital. Or these are paired electrons and they may be unpaired electrons. So they may be here with the same upward spin, with the downward spin, with upward spin, downward spin, or downward spin and upward spin. Or they may be present here, or they may be present here and here. So we have summarized and show the possible terms, possible multiplication, possible products for these terms, which we can understand after some time. So for if we see this situation, then we can see that both the electrons are paired. So the multiplicity will become A. So we will get some products from the multiplicity of the product of A1 plus B1 plus B2. And other is also A1 plus B1 plus B2. This is for T2G1 configuration and this is for T2G1 other. So this becomes T2G2. Now the combinations may be A1 into A1, A1 into B1, A1 into B2. Then other combination may be B1 A1, B1 B1, B1 B2. And the third one product, the third product may be B2 A1, B2 B1 and B2 B2. So total these are three, these are three. So total 9 combinations may be possible. So total 9 combinations may be possible. And these combinations are these. Some of these combinations are these because some are common. So in this case, so we got such kind of combinations. A1 into A1, A1 into B1 or B1 into A1, B1 into B1, B1 into B2, B2 into B1. These are 9 combinations. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So these are these 9 combinations. So we can see that if A1 is multiplied with A1, then we will get A1 term. If A1 will multiply with V1, then we will again we obtain B1. Because we have already discussed in previous lecture on ground state term for transition matter complexes, then when A multiply with any term, then the multiplication product will be the other term. So it is B1. Then when B1 B1 multiply, they will generate A1 term. When B1 and B2 term multiply, they generate A2 term. A1 and B2, they generate B2 term. And B2 and B2, they generate A1 term. So now come to this table again. So when A1 and A1, the two electrons are present in A1. So this is the product, this is in A1, this is in A1. So product of A1 and A1 is A1. And because the spin is 0, so the multiplicity will be 1. So this term is 1A1. For this term, both the electrons are present in B1. So both the electrons are present in B1. Means B1 into B1. So B1 into B1 product is equal to A1. So electrons are paired. So multiplicity will become 1. So the term becomes 1A1. Now, one electron is at A1 and other is in B1. So product is A1 into B1. So A1 into B1 is equal to B1. So this state is B1. And both have the opposite spin. So it become, the spin become 0 and multiplicity will become 1. in this case one electron is A1 and other is in B1, but both have the same spin. So the spin become 1, so it become 3. So 3B1. Now in this case it is in B1 and B2. So the product of B1 and B2 is equal to A2. And these have the different opposite spin, so it become 1. So this is 1A2. And in the similar way, this is 3A2. So we will get the different energy levels for T2G2 configuration in C2V field. So if we lower the symmetry of octahedral field to C2V, we obtain different energy levels again. So we obtain different energy levels like A1, B1, A2 and B2. Four types: A1, A2, B1 and B2. These are the four energy states. Now in octahedral field, these are the four products. These are the four products in octahedral field. If T2G2 symmetry, T2G2 configuration is there in a strong field complex, these are the terms in octahedral field, while these are the terms in C2V point group. So A1G is equal to A1. When we reduce it to C2V, it becomes A1 plus A2. From T1G, it converts into T2, B1 and B2. And for T2G, the energy terms in C2V symmetry are A1 plus B1 plus B2. Now we can see that in three octahedral terms, there are A1. In A1G, in EG and T2G, the three terms are A1. And A1 in all cases, if we see A1 in all cases, it has multiplicity 1. So A1 has multiplicity 1, while B1 may have both type of multiplicity 1 and 3, and A2 can have both type of multiplicity 3 and 1. So the terms in octahedral field which are having A1 in C2V symmetry, they should have multiplicity of 1. Because A1 has only one multiplicity, that is 1. While in case of A2 is may be triplet also. So these terms, one multiplicity terms, they can be generated from one multiplicity terms. So definitely this should be E1G and this should be T2G, should have one multiplicity because the generating terms are of one multiplicity. So the remaining T2G term should be the triplet term because it is generating the terms that are A2, B1 and B2. These may be triplet or may be singlet. So for equal degeneracy or equal microstates, this term should have three multiplicity. Now we can check the total number of microstates. In this case, the microstate will be 1. In this case, the microstate will be 2. In this case, the degeneracy is 3 and the multiplicity is 3. So the microstate will be 9. 3 3 are 9. And for this state, the microstate will be 3, so total number of microstate will equals to 15. So we have decided that this T1G state should have triplet state and others should have the singlet state. So now we get the different energy levels for T2G2 configuration. Likewise, we have to calculate or study the different terms generated from the other configurations, other excited state configurations like T2G1 and EG1 and EG2 configuration. In case of T2G1, EG1 configuration, the total degeneracy is 6 because it has 3 degeneracy, it has 2 degeneracy, so total degeneracy is 6. And for 6 degeneracy, when the product of T2G and EG is T1G into T2G, we have already studied in this ground state term for transition metal complexes. So these are the two terms. And if we calculate, so these, it has 3 degeneracy, it has 3 degeneracy. So if we put this one multiplicity on the both the terms and 3 multiplicity on both the terms, then we will get the total number of microstates of 24. It's a singularity state, so 3 degeneracy, so state microstates will be 3, microstates will be 3. Its multiplicity is 3, but its degeneracy is 3, so total number of microstates will be 9. 3, 3 are 9, so total number of microstates will be 24. And if we calculate the total number of microstates for such kind of configuration, this configuration is just like an excited state configuration, like this is like S1, P1, and this is like one electron is in T2G set and other is in EG set. So total number of microstates can be calculated. This is for T2G1 and this is for EG1. So if we multiply these, then we will get the total number of microstates are 24. So for electronic configuration in strong field, this configuration is excited state configuration. So for this, it can split into these energy levels T1G, 1T1G, 1T2G, 3T1G and 3T2G. Now come to the other configuration, that is the second excited state, EG2 configuration. And for EG2 configuration, degeneracy will be 4 and microstates will equal to 6. So if EG is multiplied with EG, then in octahedral case, we will get 3 energy levels, that are A1G, A2G and EG. By hit and trial method, we can suggest that either A1G or A2G should have 3 multiplicity. It should have 1 multiplicity. So if it is having 3 multiplicity, then it covers 6 microstates. So it should have 1 multiplicity. And either A1G or A2G should have 3 multiplicity. So if it is have 3 multiplicity, then 3 plus 2 plus 1, it is equal to 6. Or if it has 3 multiplicity, then 3 plus 1 plus 2 is equal to 6. So either this or this should have 3 multiplicity. So again, we can calculate, we can decide which state should have the multiplicity 3 by lowering the symmetry from octahedral to D4H symmetry. In case of octahedral symmetry, this EG2, so this EG2 configuration, this is octahedral and this is D4H. So if we lower the symmetry from octahedral to D4H, we can observe that this can be split into A1G and B1G. A means 1 degeneracy, B means 1 degeneracy, so total degeneracy is 2 and its degeneracy is also 2. So now these 2 electrons may be here or may be here, and there are different arrangements. This one EG has A1 plus B1 and other will also have A1 plus B1. So the product will be 4, A1 A1, A1 B1, B1 A1 and B1 B1. So we will get the 4 products. So the electron may be here A1 A1, then product may be B1 B1, then maybe A1 B1 or B1 A1. So if this, the product of A1 and A1 is A1, A1 and B1 is B1, and B1 and B1 will become A1. So for this state, it is the product of A1 and A1. Both the electrons are present in A1. For this, both the electrons are present in B1. So this is the product of B1. In this case, one electron is in A1 and other is B1. So this is the product of A1 into B1. And this is again the product of A1 and B1. So the product of A1 and B1 is B1. And the product of A1 and A1 is A1. And B1 and B1 is also A1. So because these are a paired electrons, so multiplicity will be 1, S will be 0. In this case, the multiplicity will be 3. And in this case, the multiplicity will be 1. So from this, we can conclude that In octahedral symmetry group, point group, A1G has a non-degenerate level of A1 in D4H subgroup. A2G has A2 and EG have A1 plus B1. Now again we can see that EG term and A1G term, they have A1 terms. And we can again see that these A1 terms, they have singlet state. They have multiplicity of 1. While in case of B1, there are two types of multiplicity, maybe 3 or maybe 1. So, where the term is only A1, then this A1 can be generated through an energy state with the spin multiplicity of 1. Because their multiplicity is also 1. So, these should be generated from the terms with the same multiplicity. Now, A2, because this A2 is triplet, so this will generate it from this A2G term. So, this this term A2G will have the triplet state. So, we can calculate with the help of this, then which term should be triplet and which should be singlet. So, the states of EG2 configurations now become 1A1G, 3A2G and 1EG. So, that their microstates will become 6. This is 1 into 1 is 1. 3 multiplicity into 1 degeneracy is equal to 3. 1 multiplicity into 2 degeneracy is equal to 2. So, 3 plus 2 plus 1 is equal to 6. So, microstates are 6. EG configuration is also having the number of microstates 6. So now these can split into these terms. So we have calculated. Now we have calculated or obtained the different energy states that are generated from different ground state as well as excited state configurations of strong field octahedral complexes with D2 configuration. Now we have to construct the correlation diagram. Before constructing the correlation diagram, we should arrange the energy states in the order of their increasing energy. So we have to decide which state will have the lower energy and which will have the higher energy. So there are certain rules which have to follow. So first, the highest multiplicity term has the lowest energy. So this is according to Hund rule. The highest multiplicity means the maximum number of unpaired electron energy state should be of lowest energy. Then if the states have the same multiplicity terms, then energy order will be like this. T has the smallest energy, then E and then A. The term with the highest degeneracy will be having the lowest energy. And in case of T1G and T2G, so in case of T1G, T1G should have the lower energy as it has the high symmetry term. It is high symmetry term as compared to T2G. So tentative order of their energy will be energy of T1G should be smaller than that of T2G. But some authors have shown that T2G has a smaller energy than T1G. But in our diagram, we are showing that T1G has lower energy than T2G. So that it become easy to learn the energy order of these obtained energy states. Now this is the correlation diagram for D2 configuration in octahedral field, and you can take a screenshot of this correlation diagram. So if you have taken the screenshot, then I can explain how to arrange the energy of these energy states. So in this extreme left, these are the energy states of free ion having D2 configuration. These are the energy states of weak field complexes, and these are electronic configurations of strong field complexes, and these are the energy levels of strong field complexes. Now, at the right side, we have written the strong field complexes energy states in increasing order of energy, and at the left, we have written the energy states of weak field complexes. So, we have already decided what should be the energy order. Number one, the electronic configuration, this is the ground state electronic configuration. This is first excited state electronic configuration, and this is second excited state electronic configuration. So it has lowest energy, it will intermediate energy, and it is of highest energy. Likewise, these energy states of free ions, they are according to their energy order. 3F is the ground state, we have already calculated for D2 configuration. So it will be the lowest energy term, and these are according to the Hund rule, we can arrange these. Now, in case of energy terms with maximum multiplicity, so in these terms, 3T1G, 1T2G, 1EG and 1A1G, that are generated from T2G2 configuration, the lowest energy term will be that having highest multiplicity. So 3T1G will be the lowest energy term. Then in T, E and A, we have decided that the term with maximum degeneracy should be the lowest energy term. So T2, then E, then A. We have arranged like this. Then in case of T2G1, EG1, we have four states. 3T1G, 3T2G, 1T1G and 1T2G. So we have first we have arranged this high multiplicity term has lower energy than one multiplicity term. Then in these in between these T1G, due to high symmetry, it has lowest energy. So 3T1G, 3T2G, then 1T1G, it has lower energy as compared to T2G. So we have arranged these energy. Then in case of EG2, again this term is of high multiplicity, highest multiplicity, so it is the lower energy term, lowest energy term, then double degeneracy, then single degeneracy. So we have arranged, and in this case we know that 3F term splits into three terms, and we have already splitted it in orgel diagram. So in that case 3T1G was the lowest term, then 3T2G, then 3A2G. Then a 1D configuration in octahedral field, it is split like this, that T2G has lower energy as compared to this EG. Then 3P term is split into 3T1G term, and again for 1G we have arranged the 3 degeneracy term have the lowest energy term, then 2 degeneracy, then 1 degeneracy, and among these, this T1G, due to high symmetry, it is of lowest energy, then 1S has the Mulliken term of 1A1G. We can see that these three multiplicity term, they are generated from three multiplicity term. These have one multiplicity because they are generated from one multiplicity term. These are three multiplicity. These terms, they have same multiplicity, and these are having the same multiplicity. Now we have to correlate these energy states, weak field energy states with the strong field energy states. So we will select the same symmetry terms with respect to their multiplicity. So we can see that 3T1G, then 3T1G, this is the first low first energy, and 3T1G, this is the first T1G. So we can join these two terms with a line, correlating them. Then 3T2G, here no 3T2G, so lowest 3T2G term is present here. So we have joined this 3T2G with this 3T2G. Then 3A2G, there are no 3A2G. No, we will find first 3A2G at here. So we join this with this. Now in this correlation diagram, you can check each correlation, the correlation between the same symmetry terms. You can check I have joined only those lines, only those terms which have the same symmetry. But first we have to check that state at both the sides, which should occur first. Then we will join them through a line. Now you can note that some lines I have joined through dark line, like this. This is state, this is state, and these states I have joined by the dark line, and others with the dash line. These are the joining lines. They represent the intermediate field of the complexes. This is weak field, this is strong field. So these are intermediate complexes. Now you can remember the octahedral complexes orgel diagram. So for D2 configuration, you can remember the octahedral complexes orgel diagram. You will remember, I will show you that the orgel diagram was like this, and like this. So these orgel diagrams, they are generated from this correlation diagram only. That are generated from this correlation diagram. So I will show you the octahedral the orgel diagram for the D2 configuration in octahedral field. Now you can cross check the orgel diagram for D2 octahedral complex, that this 3T1G, 3T2G, 3A2G, and this 3T1G. You can remember that these two terms, 3A2G and 3T1G, they are crossing each other. So this is the point to be noted. And if you remember the orgel diagram of D2 tetrahedra, then you can see that these two terms, this is generating from F, 4T1G, and this is the T1G of P. You can see that these two lines, they do not cross each other, but they are looking like they are repelling each other. So you should remember this point, that for D2 tetrahedra, when these two T1G terms, they are near to each other, they never cross each other. And in this diagram for D2 octahedra, they cross each other, because this is 3A2G, this is 3T1G. In this, both are T1G terms. Now we go to back to the correlation diagram for D2 configuration. So you can again check. This is like orgel diagram. So orgel diagram is generating from here this 3P term and this term. These two terms, they are crossing each other. So this is orgel diagram. Now, in case of D2 tetrahedra, you have seen that if two terms, they are near to each other, that means if both are T1G, both terms are T1G, and both have the same multiplicity. So I have ticked some terms. This term is 3T1G, and this term is also 3T1G. So this 3T1G is correlated with this 3T1G, and this is correlated with this 3T1G. These are the parallel lines. These are the parallel lines. So they never cross each other. Likewise, I made stars on this term. This is 1T2G, and this 1T2G is correlated with this 1T2G. Okay. Then the other term is 1T2G. This is correlated with 1T2G. This is the joining line. And this is the joining line. You can see that this and this line, they never cross each other. So this is the non-crossing rule. This non-crossing rule is generated from correlation diagrams. Non-crossing rule means two terms with same symmetry, similar symmetry, 1T2G, and this is also 1T2G. So two terms with the same symmetry, they never cross each other. Like this, T1G, 3T1G, and this is also 3T1G. They are parallel lines. So they never cross each other. This is non-crossing rule. And if two terms with the same multiplicity but they have different symmetry, like 3A2G and 3T1G, they can cross each other. They can cross each other. What do you mean by the non-crossing? So non-crossing means the same symmetry terms, they mix, they can easily mix because they have same symmetry. Although they are far to each other, but they can easily mix. If they are near to each other, they will mix. And if they are far, they will also mix. So if they mix, then the term with lower energy will stabilize and lower its energy, more decrease in its energy. So it will stabilize more. And the term with higher energy, it will destabilize. Actually, it will destabilize. Its energy will increase and its energy will decrease. So they never cross each other. So they may be parallel or they may be like this. So they never cross each other. So that is non-crossing rule. So according to non-crossing rule, the terms with same symmetry, they never cross each other, they mix, and the term with lower energy, it is stabilized, and the term with higher energy, it will destabilize. So they never cross each other. So we can remember that two points, that the orbital diagram can be generated from this correlation diagram, and also the non-crossing rule is also generated from this correlation diagram. Now again come to the orbital diagrams. Now you can see that in case of this D2 tetrahedra complex in orbital diagram, these two terms, they are of same symmetry terms. These terms, because they have same symmetry, so they mix, then the lower energy term will stabilize, lower energy, and this higher energy term will destabilize. Its energy will increase after mixing, so they never cross each other. In this case also, this is T1G and this is 3T1G, so you can see that they never cross each other. Its energy will lower and its energy will increases after mixing. So these term will also mix, these term will also mix. So they never cross each other. These two terms, they never cross each other. This is the non-crossing rule. Now if we want to draw correlation diagram for D2 tetrahedral complex, then we have to follow certain conditions again, and then no problem, then we can easily draw correlation diagram for D2 configuration like that of D2 in octahedral field. So for tetrahedral complex, we have to not use G. So we have to remove the G from everywhere, from electronic configuration, from any energy state. So we have to remove G because tetrahedral complexes, they have no center of symmetry, so we cannot use this G. Then for weak field complex energy terms, we have to first obtain the energy terms from weak field complexes, then from strong field complexes. So for weak field complexes, the energy of these terms will be revolted. 3A2, 3T2 and 3T1. Because as we know from crystal field theory that the splitting pattern of tetrahedral complex is opposite to that of octahedral complex. So in that case 3T1 was the lowest term, and in this case 3A2 will be the lowest energy term. Then 1D in case of octahedral complex, T2 was the lowest energy term. So because it is tetrahedral, so 1E will be the lowest energy sum. So energy term, their order will be reversed in case of tetrahedral complex, because their splitting is reversed to that of octahedral complex. So the energy order will become like this. So we have to arrange the energy order like this, and energy order of strong field complexes like this. In case of tetrahedral complex, the lowest energy term electronic configuration will be E2. Then E1, T2-1, then T2-2. So the energy state will be like that only, that of octahedral complex. But the energy order of these electronic configuration will be changed. So with the help of these points, we can construct the correlation diagram for D2 tetrahedral complexes. So these correlation diagrams, they are helpful in deciding the non-crossing rule and also for the formation of orgel diagram. So this is the importance of correlation diagrams. The correlation diagrams of other configurations are very complicated. So we can understand with the help of D2 configuration only.